Good evening. The angel Gabriel was sent by God to a city of Galilee named Nazareth, to a virgin betrothed to a man named Joseph of the house of David. The virgin's name was Mary, and having come in, the angel said to her, "Rejoice, highly favored one. The Lord is with you. Blessed are you among women." But when she saw him, she was troubled at his saying and considered what manner of greeting this was. And then the angel said to her, "Do not be afraid, Mary, for you have found favor with God, and behold, you shall conceive in your womb and bring forth a son, and you shall call his name Jesus."
Thank you.
In those days, a decree went out from Caesar Augustus that all the world should be registered. So all went to be registered, everyone to his own city. Joseph also went up from Galilee, out of the city of Nazareth, into Judea, to the city of David, which is called Bethlehem, because he was of the house and lineage of David, to be registered with Mary, his betrothed wife, who was with child. And so it was, while they were there, the days were completed for her to be delivered. And she brought forth her firstborn son, wrapped him in swaddling clothes, and laid him in a manger, because there was no room for them in the inn. Shepherds living out in the fields, keeping watch over their flock by night. And behold, An angel of the Lord stood before them, and the glory of the Lord shone around them, and they were greatly afraid. Then the angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for behold, I bring you good tidings of great joy, which will be to all people. For there is born to you this day in the city of David a Savior, who is Christ the Lord. And this will be a sign unto you. You will find the babe wrapped in swaddling clothes, lying in a manger." Shepherds rose to follow the star as it shone in the east, when suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest, and on earth peace, goodwill toward men." was when the angels had gone away from them into heaven that the shepherds said one to another, Let us now go to Bethlehem and see this thing which has come to pass, which the Lord has made known to us. And they came with haste and found Mary, Joseph, and the babe lying in a manger. Now when they had seen him, they made widely known the saying which was told to them concerning this child. Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea in the days of Herod the king. Behold, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, saying, Where is he who is born king of the Jews? For we have seen his star in the east and have come to worship him. Then Herod, when he had secretly called the wise men, determined from them what time the star appeared. When they heard the king, they departed. And behold, the star which they had seen in the east went before them, till it came and stood over where the young child was. And when they had come into the house, they saw the young child with Mary, his mother, and fell down and worshipped him. And when they had opened their treasures, they presented gifts to him, gold and frankincense and myrrh.
Thank you.
and shepherds over 2,000 years ago, we pause to remember the child sleeping in the night and his eternal promise of goodness and light.
Noche de paz, noche de amor, todo duerme en derredor, desde los astros que esparcen su luz. Everyone, please join us in singing together.
Decades, millions have been inspired by the Christmas message originally expressed in 1926 by Dr. James Allen Francis when he wrote, "He was born in an obscure village, the child of a peasant woman. He grew up in still another village where he worked in a carpenter shop until he was 30. And for 3 years, he was an itinerant preacher. He never wrote a book. He never held an office. He never had a family or owned a house. He didn't go to college. He never visited a big city. He never traveled more than 200 miles from the place where he was born. He did none of the things one usually associates with greatness. He had no credentials but himself. He was turned over to his enemies and went through the mockery of a trial. He was nailed to a cross between two thieves. While he was dying, his executioners gambled for his clothing, the only property he had on earth. And when he was dead, he was laid in a borrowed grave through the pity of a friend. Over 20 centuries have come and gone, and today he is the central figure of the human race and the leader of mankind's progress. All the armies that ever marched, all the navies that ever sailed, all the parliaments that ever sat, all the kings that ever reigned put together have not affected the life of man on this earth as much as that one solitary life.
Thank you. Lyon. And tonight's special guest narrator, Gary Sinise.
What a privilege to be up here with all these young people singing. It's so moving to see them. Aren't they great? Just give them a number. And Nancy, isn't she wonderful? She just... I've had the privilege over the past several years of spending a lot of time with our troops on the road overseas and on bases all around this country. So I want to give a special Merry Christmas and holiday message to all our families, military families that are here today, and all our veterans, and everybody serving our country overseas. God bless you. God bless America. Thank you very much, everyone.